you take your picture. Ready? 3, 2, 1, cheese. Great. It's good to see you again. Well, today I'd like to share with you a story written by Mary Morgan and illustrated by Dawn McVay Baumer. It's from the National Park Mystery Series, the first book, and it's called Stolen Treasures at Pictured Rocks. This book is filled with mystery and adventure, and see, the Cooper family thought they were just going on a vacation to the Upper Peninsula to Pictured Rocks. They're from Lansing, Michigan. Do you know where Lansing, Michigan is? Let me get out a map. Ta-da! People from Michigan often use their hand as a map because it looks kind of like a mitten. So Lansing's about here. It's the state capital, and they head up to the Upper Peninsula, and there's a lake called Lake Superior. It's one of the Great Lakes, and they're going to Pictured Rocks, which is about here. They thought they were just going on a camping trip and having a good, relaxing time. They'd eat floors, go hiking, they meet a friend, they go kayaking, it's fun. But the trip ends up being more than what they expected and bargained for. I really enjoy this story because it reminds me of my own family. We would go on vacation, we went to Picture Rocks, we went to all sorts of places when I was a kid, and it was fun and it was exciting. But sometimes unexpected things happen. Like the time when our family's vehicle broke down in a whole different state. Obviously, our plans changed. That happens in life sometimes, doesn't it? So I really feel like I can relate to Ben and Bekka. The two main characters are twins. They are often using tools on their vacation. So Ben really likes to use binoculars, and Bekka really likes taking pictures. But these end up being key tools to solving the mystery. I would love to tell you all about it, but I can't tell you right now. According to plan, but they might not. So that's my first of the discussion questions for you. When things don't go according to plan, how do you deal with it? Who helps you deal with it? Those are important things to think about because unexpected stuff will happen in life, right? Oh, and in this book, in the back, there are recipes, great delicious recipes, and there's the semaphore alphabet so you can learn it and communicate with others through that, and there's also maritime artifact pictures. But let's go back to the discussion questions. Are you more like Ben and you like to take binoculars on a trip? Or are you more like Bekka who uses a camera all the time? Or do you have a different tool you'd like to take on an adventure?